Welcome back to Hello Nigeria. It is time for our top story and our celebrity guest is here. Okay, before I constitute one of the
can you do more?
I need to do more. I can play the Remy Fasola to do.
All right, go ahead. That's like the only thing
I
can do.
So before I introduce the guest, I just need to show my talent. Just watch out. Phenomenal, Femi Laye, the original owner of this guitar. Thank you for joining us, Femi.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
What's the name of your guitar?
This is Ayo.
Ayo.
Oh. Yeah, we've met Ayo before.
Yeah,
was she Ayo when we met her?
Yeah.
Yeah, she was Ayo. I remember. Yeah.
Okay. Does she have an English name?
Ayo, Joy.
Joy.
She gives you joy.
Joy doesn't really. No. Shout out to all the joys.
My electric guitar is called Adina. Yeah,
Adina. What does Adina mean? That's a Ghanaian.
It means gorgeous, delicate, is your perfect woman.
Do you have any guitar called Initama? That's a lovely name.
You know, we are working on this.
Okay.
No, instead of having a guitar that has name, why don't you have the person?
Love that answer.
Okay, they won't understand that.
Congratulations on your recent engagement,
thank you.
Femi just got engaged to me.
You shouldn't have mentioned that our few viewers that were tripping for him will now change channel.
It doesn't change anything for them.
No, they won't.
Not change channel.
I'm still somebody out there for everyone.
Yeah. They'll say it's just engaged. In fact, any that should change the channel.
All right, Femi, so let's start from the very beginning. Mm-hmm. Now you're doing so many things. You're into music, you play the guitar, mm-hmm. and recently I learned that you're also an actor. So which one came first?
Music has always been the first, you know. But, you know, music gives you that opportunity to, you know, expand frontiers, and you realize that you're actually talented in other areas. I've always been told that, oh, you're funny, you're witty, you're this, you're that. So I just decided to dabble into theater, and I've done it twice, and it's been very, very interesting.
Twice?
Yeah. And I can testify to that. I mean, who would know that you were a novice? Not really a novice, I mean.
But like
who
a
would
freshman.
Know it was your first
No one.
Where did it start from? What did you study in university?
I did food science and technology.
Wow.
So I'm a scientist. Yeah, so this food. Is like... No,
I like the way you said it. When people study food science and technology, I'm sure what comes to your mind is you're a foodie.
Exactly. No, you're look at me now. I'm not, you know, I'm just very...
Forget it. People that have this kind of body, they are the most deceptive bodies. When they start
I can attest to that.
Food.
It's true. It's true. I eat a lot.
Eat a lot. And then you think, let me eat like this person. And we're going our bantering with eating, and then you'll be expanding and
digesting.
You know the amazing thing about having this kind of body is that you can eat at 12 a.m. And you're fine.
So painful.
Like, I'll come back from a show and I'm, you know, hungry. I just go to the kitchen and just make something. I just eat.
Just hold on.
I sleep like 3 a.m.
Some
and you're
of
fine.
Our people behind the scene are very jealous of you and they're telling you that your life
comes. I apologize. You know,
you're going to get married. Your wife will stuff you with food. And next time I'll see you have a little pot belly in front.
Femi, at what point did you realize that, look, there was something extra and special about you? Did you start paying attention to your creative abilities?
I think it was immediately after secondary school. I think as a GSS 2, I wanted to go to a music school. You know, my parents are very traditional, so they wouldn't even like that. That period was like computer school or
doctor
lesson
before you get into the university. And I was like, no way, you didn't allow me to go GS 2, I'm just going to do my own thing. So when I was about 14, 15, I started learning. You know, I started learning before, but it wasn't a real guitar. It was like a makeshift guitar. Yeah. So I got a guitar and I started learning by myself and I started playing. And by the time I got into school, I realized that, you know, it was cool. Food science is cool. Being a nerd, I was a nerd actually. I would have actually finished with a distinction if it wasn't going to Lagos and coming back every time. Yeah. But I realized in school that I wanted to do music so bad. I had a band of like 10 people playing for me as a player.
And
at that time in school, I had vocalists, I had bass players, I had everybody. And we'll go around, you know, different churches and playing, you know, different shows, direct music for this, direct music for that. And it was just, at that point, I knew that
it was.
So I wasn't staying in school, you know. And by the time I finished, I just packed my bags. Told my father, so I did well in school. This is your certificate. This is yours. Now I'm going.
Like
bye. And it's been 10 years.
Wow.
Yeah. Fantastic.
Now, you say that you prefer, because you're a recording artist, but also you're very famous for your live performances.
Yeah.
Now, just like in film, where some people prefer stage acting to you know, to the screen acting, which is your favorite? Where do you feel more empowered? Stage
I love the stage. The stage.
Instant feedback.
Exactly. And, you know, the crowd, the adrenaline, everything about
then
it is so interesting.
Then a little bit of a madman on stage. Jumping up and down.
And that was why it was important for me to have a live album, because it justifies the fact that you're a musician. You know, the funny thing about having a live album is, you can auto-tune your voice.
Yeah, you can't say, DJ, hit me, track two.
You can't edit, you can't cut. So everything you say will be recorded, and that's it. And if you listen to the Ekabo live album, you understand and the feel to it, the crowd, the screams, and you know the funny thing? We actually forgot to use a mic for audience reaction. So to pick up, you know, normally when you have live recording, you have, we forgot. And then the scream was so loud, it came from my own mic. So there was no way, even if we wanted to auto-tune in the studio, it wasn't going to happen. We auto-tune people. It would be very, very funny. And, you know, it was so loud. Like, there was a point I was playing, I think I was playing Ayo. I saw my mom and my dad on the floor. My godmom, everybody, let me use this word, barraged, you know, on the dance floor. And people were shouting and people were screaming. I remember I did a cover of Uptown Funk and we did like an Afro jazz version with horns and everything, and it was so rad. And people were so for me, playing live is just the ultimate. And like, I can't wait to go on stage every single time. It's
you've done a lot of live recordings, and you finally put them into an album.
Put this one together. It was at my concert, I called it the Ekabo concert, so it became the Ekabo live album, and it was. Till date, that's my best.
The name Ekabo, what was going on? What's the story behind it?
Well, coming into the industry, welcome to the world of Femile. Coming into the music industry, I've worked with a lot of people, but then people didn't really know what I was about as a guitarist, as a singer, as a producer. So I needed to introduce people to my life and my faith also as a Christian. So it was the beginning of Ekabo, and I've really transitioned from when I released the album in 2015. To now, my life has really, really changed. And I understand.
Wait, you released this album in 2015?
Yeah, but you've been
not the Ekabo live album, the Ekabo album.
Yeah, but you've been doing music actively for 10 years.
I'm going to 15 years now.
What's the 10 to 15 years, you've paid your dues.
Oh, I paid it.
And
I'm not paying dues anymore.
What lessons did you learn? What were the ups and downs?
It's just like anything in life, was very, very challenging. You know, if you want to, you have to be deliberate. You cannot say, oh, I want to make it in life, and you expect someone to help you. No one gave me a chance. I was in Laro, then I came to Songo, and I had to leave to come to Lagos, and I squatted with different people.
Wow.
I can tell you for a fact that 80% of the shows I've played in my life has been free shows. But because I just wanted to put myself out there, you know, work with different artists. In fact, there was a time I remember Infinity back in the day, I wanted to be their guitarist so bad. I met one of the members and told me, oh, they had two people. I said, don't worry, don't pay me. I will play. You know, but as God will have it, some people heard me play and I started working with a couple of people, played in churches for free.
Speaking of hearing you play, we're going to hear you play shortly, but we would like to quickly wrap up so that we can leave you to play shortly. Okay. So your album is, Ekabo live album is out. Where can people get it?
Everywhere. iTunes, Deezer, Spotify, Music Plus, every online platform that sells music, you can get it right now. Please support us.
Please, Apple. He's planning wedding.
I endorse that message because it's quality music and we celebrate. Great.
Thank you. Very true.
You guys have always been supporting me.
Thank you so much for joining us today. Thank you very much indeed for coming.
Thank you.
All right. What's happening today in history?
I'll just say what happened today in history. Happy birthday to all those who are celebrating today. We really rejoice with you. And I'm particularly excited to say the first one because when Femi Leye speaks, I'm sure he would count one of these men as his mentors. Sonny Ade was born today in history. Sonny Ade.
That's the reason why I started playing the guitar in the first place.
I knew that. Yeah. There's no way. King Sunday Adegeye is his real name, it's King Sunny Ade. Yeah. Very popular
man.
Last year, he celebrated his 70th. Yeah. So this year, he's 71. Happy birthday. I don't even need to introduce him because he needs no introduction.
You know, that's what you aspire to be. Yeah. You know, at that age, just keep performing.
You know something.
And you know, music is so powerful. You guys don't have a retirement age.
We don't.
I mean, the Rolling Stones are still jamming.
All right. We also have Owele Rochas Anayo Okorocha, who was born today in history. He's the governor of Imo State. 28. Happy birthday. He's famous. He had a lot of cakes.
He's also a philanthropist.
He has 27 cakes besides from the local.
Yeah, but he's also a philanthropist. He has a Rochester Culture Foundation.
Yeah, which is fantastic.
Yeah, fantastic.
I think there's something special about September babies. I was born in September.
Of course you think there's something good. Happy birthday to actor Majid Michael. Michelle, happy birthday to you indeed.
I think he's one of the most humble people I've met. We went on set, he kept taking pictures with people at the mall, and everybody wanted to take pictures with him. He wouldn't say no. And he was smiling all through, regardless of how tired he was.
That's a good thing.
Keeps teaching. What I learned from there is no matter how far you get in life, you always remember that your fans are the ones that make you.
True that.
So happy birthday to Majid Michelle from all of us here on Hello Nigeria. Remember, you can follow us on Twitter at WazobiaMax with the hashtag Hello Nigeria. It's time for us to go away from here, but not before we leave you in the hands of Femi Leye. See you on Monday.
Femi, when is your birthday, by the way?
September. September. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Fast.
Yara di day, ise logo ise. Yara di day, ore lo wa sese. Yara di day, ise logo ise. Yara di day, ore lo wa sese. Sise, sise, ma sere, sere, sise, 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 ore mi sise, sise, ma sere, sere, sise. Sise, ani sise, sise ore mi sise, sise, ma sere, sere, sise, 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 sise ore mi sise, sise, ma sere, sere, sise, 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 sise ore mi.
Follow Femi Leye on Instagram, on Twitter, at Femi Leye One, right?
Yes.
Follow him on all social media portals. Support his music, buy his music, invite him to play at your wedding, invite him to play at your grandmother's burial.
It's okay,
you know, everything. And follow us individually, Ayo at AyoThompson7 on Twitter, AyoThompson on Instagram, Benga at Captain Tankara, yours truly at Oliver Modi, and collectively at WazobiaMax with the hashtag Hello Nigeria.
Don't drink and drive. Have a fantastic weekend, and we'll see you on the other side.
So we have to do a freestyle for Hello Nigeria. It's a tradition. Anyone who comes to the kitchen does that. While we go away.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.